Hi friends, today we see damp proofing, the important point in building foundation for maintaining its services and protect the building foundation from dampness. First of all, what is mean by DPC? DPC is damp proof course. Damp proof course is generally applied at basement levels, which restrict the movement of moisture through walls and floors. Selection of materials for damp roof course and its various methods of application in building we discuss in this lecture. Dampness is coming from walls and through floors. We have to take care of restrict the dampness from atmosphere to enter into the building. Next point is materials for damp proof course. Properties of material should be for damp proof course are: it should be impervious, means the moisture does not pass through it. It should be strong and durable and should be capable of withstanding both dead as well as live loads without damage. It should be dimensionally stable. It does not change dimensions when applied any kind of load. And last properties, it should be free from deliquescent salts like sulfates, chlorides and nitrates. Next is types of materials for damp proof course. The materials commonly used to check dampness can be divided into the three categories. First one is flexible materials. Materials like bitumen pellets, which may be resin based or fibers, glass fiber based, plastic sheeting, that are polythene sheets. Next is semi-rigid materials, in which the materials like mastic, asphalt or combination of materials or layers. And last is rigid materials, in which the materials like first class bricks, stones, slate, cement, concrete and etc. Selection of materials for damp proof course in building. The choice of material is function as an effective damp proof course requires a judicious selection. It depends upon the climate and atmospheric conditions, nature of structure and the situation where damp proof course is to be provided. The points to be kept in view while making selection of damp proof course materials are: damp proof course above ground level. For damp proof course above ground level with wall thickness generally not exceeding 40 cm, any one of the type of materials mentioned may be used. Cement concrete is, however, commonly adopted material for damp proof course at plinth level. 38 to 50 mm thick layer of cement concrete of grade M15 of concrete mix design 1:2, 2:4 mix serves the purpose under normal condition. In case of damp and humid atmosphere, richer mix of concrete should be used. The concrete is further made dense by adding waterproofing materials like impermo, waterlock, etc. In its ingredients, during the process of mixing. It is used to apply 2 coats of hot bitumen over the third surface of the concrete damp proof course. Second is damp proof course material for floors, roofs, etc. For greater wall thickness or where damp proof course is to be laid over large area such as floors, roofs, the choice is limited to flexible materials which provides lesser number of joints like mastic, asphalt, bitumen fields and plastic sheets. The fields when used should be properly bonded to the surface with bitumen and laid with joints properly lapped and sealed. Third is damp proof course material for situations where differential thermal moments occurs. In parapet walls and other such situations, materials like mastic, asphalt, bitumen, felts and metal are recommended. The metals are copper or lead. It is important to ensure that the DPC or damp proof course material is flexible so as to avoid any damage or puncture of the material due to differential thermal moment between the material of the roof and the parapet. And last is damp proof course material for cavity walls. In cavity walls construction, like cavity over the door or window, should be reached by flexible materials like bitumen, felt and strips or lead. Next is methods of damp roof course installation in construction. In general, principle to be observed while laying damp roof course are: the damp roof course should cover full thickness of walls excluding rendering. The mortar bed upon which the damp roof course is to be laid should be made level, even and free from projection. Uneven basis is likely to cause damage to damp roof course. When a horizontal damp roof course is to be continued up a vertical face, a cement concrete fillet 75 mm in radius should be provided at the junction prior to the treatment, and each damp proof course should be placed in correct relation to other damp proof course so as to ensure complete and continuous barrier to the passage of water from floors, walls or roofs. In figure, the dam proof course is in the form of air drain. In air drain is provided in masonry and the damp proof course is provided. The opening at regular intervals with grillings are provided in the masonry like shown in figure. The damp proof course are provided in the form of air drain. In this diagram, the damp proof course treatment for basement or undrained soil, in which the drain pipes are provided in the foundation in the form of pipes. The dampness are coming in the wall are drained through drain pipe. The damp proof cores or sheets are provided in masonry in vertical and horizontal. The damp proof cores is provided before flooring and trench filled with gravel for collecting dampness, and the dampness is drained through drain pipe. Next is the figure shows the plan of building showing damp proof course in which the drains also are provided. Before main walls, the damp proof course is provided around the main wall, and the drains also provided for draining moisture, and the slope also provided for collecting the moisture through drain pipes. The catch drain also provided. Next is damp proof course treatment for basement in damp soil. In the figure, the main reinforced concrete is protected by damp proof course. The half brick protective wall for protected the damp proof course. In foundation, the flat brick course and foundation concrete also provided for protecting damp proof course. Next is asphalt tanking for basement, in which the basement is protected by asphalt sheets in the basement. Next is damp proof course for flooring. Before flooring, the damp proof course are provided, in which the lean concrete, then damp proof course, and then flooring is provided. The figure shows also the damp proof course which is laid after the bed of lean concrete, then DPC course, then flat bricks, and the next is flooring is provided. Thank you.